The rift between Gervonta Davis and Floyd Mayweather Jr., his mentor and promoter, appears to have escalated ahead of Ryan Garcia's upcoming bout with Devin Haney. We know that Gervonta Tank Davis has been a prominent figure under the Mayweather Promotions banner, having been mentored by Floyd Mayweather himself. This relationship has been more than just promoter and fighter. It was a mentorship and bond that seemed to transcend the business aspects of boxing. Mayweather, a legendary figure in the sport, took Davis under his wing, guiding him through the complexities of professional boxing both inside and outside the ring. However, the world of boxing is no stranger to rivalries, and the one brewing between Gervonta Davis and Ryan Garcia has been particularly intense. Both fighters, young, ambitious, and at the top of their game, have made no secret of their mutual disdain. This rivalry has not only captured the attention of boxing fans worldwide, but has also added a layer of intrigue to the relationships within Mayweather Promotions. The announcement that Floyd Mayweather would be working with Ryan Garcia, especially ahead of Garcia's bout against Devin Haney, sent shockwaves through the boxing community. Talking to Haney, Garcia said, "Your dad is a pimp, and he's pimping you. I'm gonna beat you. I'm gonna beat you. Pussy, you suck. Your dad can't talk for you. Your dad can't save you." However, Haney fired back, saying, "I beat the shit out of Tank. I'll beat the shit out of you." When asked about the upcoming fight, Ryan Garcia said, "I got a great team. I don't mess around when it comes to trying to make the biggest fights happen. There's a lot of things, but it's here. What does it matter? It's here. I'm just like that, and they're going to find out. I'm like that." Garcia further added, "Devin Haney needs to stop the pimping game. He's pimping his own son. Tell him to fuck off. I can't wait for you guys to see. April 20th, buy your tickets." We'll get into more of this when I have time to really digest the questions. But as of right now, start praying for Devin. However, the most shocking thing was when Garcia said, "We have seen that video when Tank beat you, Floyd showed me." Moreover, he added, "Devin is getting pimped by his dad, the pimp, sad to see. 4-20, he will be crying, begging, please have mercy. Save your son, Bill." These remarks escalated things further. Mayweather's decision to train Garcia, given the latter's direct rivalry with Davis, has been perceived by many, including Davis himself, as a betrayal. This move by Mayweather has raised questions about loyalty, business decisions, and the intricate dynamics of boxing promotions. Gervonta Davis's reaction to Mayweather's involvement with Garcia was swift and public. Through social media, Davis expressed his displeasure and sense of betrayal, going as far as to claim that he had blocked Mayweather. This public declaration of a rift between mentor and mentee highlights the emotional and personal stakes involved in the sport of boxing, beyond just the fights that take place in the ring. According to insiders, Davis stated that he had always looked up to Floyd Mayweather as more than just a promoter, viewing him as a mentor and a guiding light in his career. Therefore, seeing Mayweather working with Garcia felt like a betrayal to him. He emphasized that the situation was not merely about business, but was personal to him. At its core, the tension between Davis and Mayweather highlights the business aspect of boxing. Decisions that may seem personal are often driven by financial considerations, promotional strategies, and the pursuit of legacy-defining fights. Mayweather's decision to train Garcia could be seen as a strategic move, one that places the interests of the promotion and the sport above individual relationships.
Love it. Last question, are we going to see Davis Garcia too, the rematch?
It all depends. I mean, because, you know, it's up to them too.
Right.
Still a big money fight.
Huge.
It was a hell of a fight. First fight. Like I said, it was a minor setback, but a major comeback in his last fight.
Right.
Hot back, made some millions, enjoying life, living life. That's what it's about.
Insiders revealed that, according to Davis, they shared a bond that transcended boxing, which now seems to have been shattered. He mentioned that he had to block Mayweather on social media because he couldn't bear to see him supporting Garcia, especially given the known rivalry between them. However, this is not it. Floyd Mayweather has recently confirmed the rumors surrounding Gervonta Davis and Ryan Garcia. This confirmation sparked a massive face-off and a plethora of drama between Team Haney and Ryan Garcia. After Haney and Garcia announced their fight, we saw intense drama unfolding. According to sources sources close to Floyd Mayweather, he confirmed that there was indeed an altercation between Gervonta Davis and Devin Haney, describing it as unfortunate that things escalated to such a level, but acknowledging it as part of the intensity and drama inherent in the sport. Mayweather further mentioned that as a promoter and mentor, he always hopes for professionalism and respect among fighters. However, he recognized that emotions can run high, especially with so much at stake. He emphasized the importance of addressing these incidents and moving forward with a focus on the upcoming fight between Haney and Garcia, underlining that ultimately, it is about showcasing their skills in the ring. Ryan Garcia delves into what Floyd Mayweather disclosed and witnessed between Devin Haney and Gervonta Davis. This incident, long discussed and speculated upon, now has credible eyewitness testimony and even video evidence. Before delving into the specifics of the altercation involving Gervonta and Floyd, as well as the deal between Devin Haney and Ryan Garcia, let's explore the full scope of the situation.
Nobody would do business with you if you act like this. Mm.
But it happens a lot in boxing, though, right?
Oh, yeah, because it's strategic.
To be common in boxing, yeah.
Floyd was telling him all these things.
Floyd's giving this counsel to Gervonta.
Yes. Who do you think is telling him to do the rehydration clauses and not, you know, putting all these stipulations on me? You can't do this. You can't do that. The ring needs to be this size. It's Davis Garcia. It's not. All these things were all by Floyd.
So, it appears that what Adrian Broner mentioned holds true. Gervonta Davis indeed sparred with Devin Haney, resulting in Davis knocking Haney out while he was on his feet, visibly wobbly. Ryan Garcia brought this up during a heated exchange between Devin and himself following the announcement of their upcoming fight scheduled for April 20th. Ryan Garcia mentioned that despite his respect for Devin as a fighter, he couldn't overlook the recent incident. He acknowledged that the issue had been a topic of conversation for some time and now, with Mayweather's confirmation, it had become public knowledge. However, Garcia emphasized that what ultimately matters is the outcome in the ring on April 20th. He stated his focus on training hard and his commitment to delivering an unforgettable fight for the fans. Regarding the spar, it clearly confirms the occurrence of the event, dispelling doubts raised by those who questioned the authenticity of Broner's or Davis's claims. Devin Haney, like any other boxer, is susceptible to being shaken up if struck on the chin by someone as powerful as Gervonta Davis. This shouldn't come as a shock to anyone, given the fighting style of Gervonta Davis. However, this doesn't imply that Devin Haney lacks the capability to defeat Davis in a bout. While Davis may possess a formidable fighting style, Haney is a skilled and evolved boxer. His past as an amateur fighter may not directly translate to his present abilities in the ring, making him a challenging target. Haney's proficiency as a fighter is evident, placing him in the upper echelon of boxing talent. It's important to note that Ryan Garcia isn't Gervonta Davis, so even if Davis managed such a feat, it doesn't guarantee a similar outcome against Haney.
That we're making more noise than the real fights. I was like, I always knew that me and Gervonta were going to be a huge fight. Anyways, I'm in a horrible place before the Gervonta. I'm in a horrible place.
Tell me what you mean by that.
Spiritually, just in my relationship and just all that I'm doing in my life. Like, I'm going hate.
Regarding the upcoming fight, fans are genuinely excited about it. It's a matchup that promises excitement and quality boxing. Ryan Garcia consistently delivers thrilling performances in the ring. None of his fights are dull. Rest assured, the bout between Devin Haney and Ryan Garcia won't resemble a lackluster match like Jermaine Ortiz versus Teofimo Lopez. Adrian Broner said, "It's interesting to note the shifting narrative surrounding Devin Haney, particularly regarding his branding and the discussions involving other fighters. Garcia will undoubtedly come out swinging, aiming to knock out Haney, who will be equally focused on defending his title. Haney will employ his defensive skills and boxing prowess to outmaneuver Garcia. However, with Garcia's lightning-fast hands and formidable power, the tension will persist throughout the fight. Fans anticipate an electrifying showdown between two talented fighters."
Haywire. But I can't pull out because they're going to say the worst of me. But I said, okay, let me put my big boy boots on and let's get to it. I told myself, against everything everybody told me, don't do it. Don't take the rehydration clause, blah, 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 all the things that he...
At times, I find it challenging to distinguish Devin Haney, the fighter, from the branding associated with DHP and the narratives involving him and other fighters. There's been significant chatter surrounding Gervonta Davis and Ryan Garcia leading up to their fight, initially questioning Garcia's worthiness as an opponent for Davis. However, now the same critics are comparing Garcia to legendary boxers like Roberto Duran, harking back to the era of the Four Kings. Before Gervonta faced Ryan, there were discussions about the Four Kings, Teofimo Lopez, Lopez, Devin Haney, Shakur Stevenson, and Gervonta Davis. To reiterate, it was Devin Haney, Ryan Garcia, Teofimo Lopez, and Gervonta Davis who were regarded as the four kings at that time, particularly during Ryan's bout with Gervonta. Suddenly, Ryan ceased to be considered one of the four kings. He was no longer regarded as a king within that group. While the other three retained their status as kings, Ryan was excluded from that designation. Consequently, the discussion shifted to the notion that when you're part of the four kings, defeats among members are expected.
And I was ready to fight him. I said, let's run it in October. It was in July. I fought Javier. I said, let's run it in October. They played with me. They said, it'll be October. Then they said, nope, we're going to do December. I said, okay, let's do December. I'm ready. I can't be on a break too long because I like to move. Like, I gotta be doing something.
However, Ryan's exclusion from this group alters the dynamics. Comparisons were drawn to historical matchups, such as when Sugar Ray Leonard faced Roberto Duran. Despite Duran's loss to Leonard, it didn't diminish his reputation as a skilled fighter. Instead, it contributed to his evolution as a boxer. Similarly, when Marvin Hagler fought Duran, his victory didn't discredit Duran's abilities. According to Broner, the discussion around the Four Kings and the historical matchups provides valuable context for understanding the significance of this fight in the broader landscape of boxing history. After Thomas Hearns was knocked out by Sugar Ray Leonard, his status as a skilled fighter didn't diminish. He remained a respected boxer, even though he wasn't considered one of the four kings when he fought Leonard. However, his stature changed when he faced Marvelous Marvin Hagler. The key here is consistency and giving all fighters the respect they deserve. If they're deemed four kings, they should maintain that status throughout their careers. It's important to acknowledge that the original four kings, like Roberto Duran, were in a league of their own. Duran, for instance, had been a multi-year champion since the early 1970s and was highly established in his weight division. Broner expressed, the tension between Gervonta and Floyd adds another layer of complexity to the dynamics within Mayweather Promotions, raising questions about loyalty and business decisions in the world of boxing. Meanwhile, Sugar Ray Leonard had already clinched an Olympic gold medal and multiple world championships before facing Tommy Hearns, who was also a seasoned world champion. Marvelous Marvin Hagler, reigning as the champion at 160 pounds, added to the mix of formidable fighters. Despite the Four Kings moniker, only one of them held a championship when the term was coined. It's an intriguing discussion, and I'm eagerly anticipating these upcoming fights. On the other hand, it appears that after all these years, now might be the perfect time for Gervonta Davis to part ways with Mayweather.
When he came undisputed, he waited till Cambosis won the belt for him to fight for the belt. You see, when Teofimo had the belt, they didn't fight. As quick as he fought with Cambosis, he could have fought with Teofimo, both all of them on the same side. He have all them belts and people don't know him. He can't fighting in his hometown and can't set it up. So
he felt betrayed when Mayweather went ahead and trained Ryan Garcia, knowing there was tension between Garcia and Davis. Imagine this. Gervonta Davis, known for his candidness both in and out of the boxing ring, didn't just raise an eyebrow at the news. He unleashed his frustration on social media. Why? Because Floyd Mayweather, the boxing legend, is reportedly training Ryan Garcia. Talking about betrayal, Davis didn't hold back, expressing his disappointment. The boxing community, always hungry for drama, was caught off guard by this bombshell. Davis, with the expected casual aggression, echoed the sentiments of many in the boxing world. Switching sides like that isn't how you show loyalty, Floyd. And that Instagram post from Davis? It ignited the internet, with fans and fellow fighters diving into the virtual ring to share their thoughts. Trust me, there won't be a dull moment in this soap opera.
What message you have for Haney?
Not wrong, but he need to focus on May the 20th. We'll holler at him after. I don't really want to speak on him. This is my moment.
Here's the twist. The news is still unconfirmed, leaving us all on the edge of our seats, awaiting official statements from Mayweather and Garcia's camps. Rumors are swirling, and the drama is thickening faster than an overcooked stew. The fallout from this bombshell could have ripple effects on relationships within the boxing community. Now let's rewind to April 2023. Picture this. Ryan Garcia suffers a TKO loss to Gervonta Davis. Ouch. The first defeat for the young gun in a highly anticipated showdown. Fast forward a bit, and suddenly, bam, videos surface of Garcia training with none other than Floyd Money Mayweather. Speculation about Garcia signing with Mayweather Promotions skyrockets, and the intrigue deepens. Floyd himself adds fuel to the fire by suggesting he's open to collaborating with Garcia if circumstances permit, but he's not actively pursuing him.
Tell them they're still on that side. If we ain't fighting each other, keep my name out y'all mouth, bro.
Yeah.
If we fighting, then let's get it.
You feel like they antagonizing it to sell more shit for them, or like what you think the reason is that it keep like that it happened like that?
I mean, I don't know, cause you always see interviews with my name and this probably pushing 60. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's cool. That's cool, but why you keep mentioning me?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
How your son to do something like that? Because his son ain't really...
Anybody say
his son ain't really like that.
Mm.
You know what I mean? That's why he got to do all the talk. He got to do all the woofing at the mouth. You know what I mean?
Right.
His son ain't really... His son ain't soft-ass nigga.
Mm. Okay. Okay. That's, I like that.
Garcia must make the decision willingly. Mayweather even provides insights into contractual obligations, legal matters, and the intricacies of boxing. Who could have predicted that a video of Garcia's training session with Mayweather would surface on the internet, captivating fans like popcorn at a movie? Floyd Mayweather expressed his admiration for Ryan's talent and dedication to the sport, emphasizing that boxing is not only a business but also a brotherhood. He mentioned that over the years, he has mentored many fighters and is always looking for ways to support the next generation of champions. Twitter is buzzing with one tweet hinting that Mayweather might be sharing the winning strategy with Garcia, the same one that helped Davis defeat Garcia initially. Talk about strategic maneuvers on the boxing chessboard. But hold on, there's an additional twist. We know that following Garcia's TKO loss to Davis, he got medically suspended for some time. Golden Boy Promotions, Garcia's current promoter, outlined plans for his comeback, targeting mid-November. And after all the discussions about potential opponents, we finally got the announcement of his fight with Haney.
Well, what do you think? You saw the thing where I was talking about Devin Haney?
Yeah.
What do you think?
I think he'll beat him in a street fight. Obviously, he's going to think he's going to win, but, you know, reality...
He'd have to knock me out first punch.
He's not going to do that, though. You understand? Like, and I'm not just saying for him, even for me. It'd be hard for me to just come in and just knock you out.
It's also, too, like, I could just kick your legs from a distance.
You could kick my leg. Once you grab me, it's a wrap. I'm looking at it with truth. I mean, I know that I'm not going to come in dumb. You know, I'm going to try to move, like, try to, like, find a shot. But, I mean, if you get me, you get me, you know?
Now, let's pivot a bit and focus on Devin Haney, the WBC super lightweight champion, and his simmering rivalry with Garcia. These two have a rich amateur history, with conflicting reports about their head-to-head record. Haney isn't pleased about Garcia cozying up to Mayweather, and he doesn't hesitate to voice his discontent on Instagram. Are we witnessing a public feud? In one corner, we have Haney cautioning Garcia that Floyd can't rescue or assist him. And what's Garcia's retort? A dismissive, cry me a river. Haney stated that seeing Ryan train with Mayweather doesn't bother him, as he has been diligently preparing for their upcoming showdown on April 20th by working hard in the gym every day. He emphasized that regardless of Ryan's training choices, he is confident in his abilities and ready to demonstrate why he is the true champion. The online boxing arena ignites, and fans find themselves in the midst of this social media feud. Some dub it as amusing, while others question the necessity of airing private messages on such a public platform. However, this isn't Haney's inaugural clash when it comes to criticizing Mayweather. He's been down this road before.
I mean, that was all part of the plan. You know, taking these guys off my, checking them off my checklist, you know, putting them all on my resume, and Ryan Garcia is just another name.
Haney has previously lambasted Mayweather for what he perceives as the detrimental fixation on maintaining an undefeated record, which, in his view, stagnates the sport's evolution. He advocates for a shift in boxing culture. Strap in, as this rivalry is just heating up in the unpredictable realm of professional boxing, where alliances shift like desert sands and drama unfolds quicker than a heavyweight punch. Fans are left eagerly anticipating the next chapter of the Haney-Garcia saga.
I mean, Ryan has always been a good fighter, you know, since we were kids. But, you know, I felt like, you know, over time I've just, you know, grown past him, you know, gotten a lot better, where Ryan kind of, you know, stayed the same. And that's for me to show on April the 20th.
However, it appears that this saga is just getting started, with more surprises and challenges ahead. Every twist and turn, every jab and hook in this story of betrayal, redemption, and the art of boxing is worth witnessing. Now, let's explore further into the fallout of Davis's bombshell revelation. The reverberations of his Instagram post are still echoing throughout the boxing world, igniting discussions and speculation about Mayweather's true connection with Garcia. Davis remarked that the drama involving Mayweather and Garcia is merely the beginning. He stressed that he won't shy away from expressing his thoughts because loyalty is paramount to him. He noted that Mayweather's lack of response is very telling, and he is adamant about not holding back until he receives some answers. The unconfirmed nature of the news has heightened the intrigue, leaving fans and experts eagerly anticipating official statements. Davis, known for his resolve, once again took to social media to address the ongoing discussion. Through a series of Instagram stories, he reiterated his disbelief at Mayweather's alleged betrayal, expressing his frustration vividly. Meanwhile, Mayweather has maintained a mysterious silence, adding to the drama's suspense. The lack of a clear confirmation or denial from Mayweather's side has only fueled speculation, with fans speculating about the possible reasons behind this unexpected partnership. In the boxing world, notorious for rumors and conjecture, various narratives have emerged around the situation. There are murmurs suggesting that Mayweather perceives a reflection of his younger self in Garcia, viewing this as an opportunity to impart his legacy and wisdom to the next generation. Alternatively, some speculate it could be a strategic maneuver to gain an advantage in the ongoing rivalry between Garcia and Davis, adding a psychological dimension to the conflict.
Well, listen, Henry, his dad is going to be there too, so we'll see who stops it. I think his dad will be the one throwing in the towel and stopping the fight.
As the virtual exchange of words between Davis and Mayweather unfolds, attention naturally shifts to Ryan Garcia. The young fighter finds himself embroiled in this high-stakes drama, yet has refrained from making an official statement. Garcia's social media presence remains surprisingly muted, leaving fans eager for any insight into his perspective on the brewing controversy. The ambiguity surrounding Garcia's future has ignited discussions within the boxing community regarding its potential ramifications on his career. Some contend that joining forces with Mayweather could elevate Garcia's abilities to unprecedented levels, considering Mayweather's iconic stature and unparalleled technical expertise. However, others raise concerns about whether this partnership might overshadow Garcia's distinctiveness and personal style, potentially transforming him into a mere reflection of Mayweather instead of allowing him to flourish independently.
Around. Any reason why you're looking around? Somebody?
I'm just trying to see that coward in front of me, though. You know, I'm trying to address it straight up. Let him know, Devin Haney, not fucking friends. Don't fucking come at me like that. Get off my phone. Don't hit my line.
Hey, I can tell you're serious, man. I guess you want to get into why it's not friends anymore?
Yeah, because these dudes, they try to make you soft by trying to be super nice to you and smile in your face and then stab you in the back when it's time. I'm not going to let that happen. I see right through you. You're fake. You're a phony. Your dad's a phony. Everybody is a phony around you.
So when it came time to sign the contract, he was delaying? He was playing around?
Oh, yeah. You know, we called. He talked to me on the phone. And he was like, you know, he expressed what he wants. And then I said, okay, let me see what I could do here. But then I caught it. Like, he was being extra nice. I'm like, bro, cut that already. Calm down, bro. No. We're not friends. Stop, bro. We're not. Don't try to soften me up. You're a weirdo.
Amidst the turmoil, another subplot emerges, the strained relationship between Garcia and Oscar De La Hoya. We know that De La Hoya, who played a pivotal role in Garcia's ascent to fame, has yet to address the situation publicly. Speculation runs rampant regarding the potential impact on Garcia's contractual commitments and the broader dynamics between fighter and promoter. The realm of social media, always ripe for drama, has now become the battleground where fans, pundits, and fellow fighters alike express their views. Memes, hashtags, and impassioned discussions flood platforms like Twitter and Instagram, transforming the digital space into a virtual arena where loyalties are tested and opinions clash. Amidst the uncertainty and conjecture, one thing remains evident. The Haney-Garcia rivalry has taken an unforeseen turn, evolving into a multi-dimensional narrative with Mayweather serving as the unexpected catalyst. So, what's on the horizon in this roller coaster of a storyline? Will Mayweather finally break his silence and provide clarity to the boxing community? How will Garcia navigate the storm swirling around him? And what repercussions will this have on his career path? Will Davis and Mayweather settle their differences through verbal battles or find common ground in the spirit of the sport? Get ready, because the drama is far from over. The plot thickens as alliances shift and the art of boxing continues to craft its unpredictable narrative. In a world where every move is analyzed, every word carries weight, and every fight becomes a chapter in an ongoing saga, one thing is certain. The Haney-Garcia saga has cemented its place in boxing history, with the story still far from reaching its final chapter. So, that's all from today's video. If you enjoyed it, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and ring that bell icon so you never miss our upcoming videos.